My apologies, I cannot do this. I cannot claim these words as my own. They're someone else's entirely. Truth be told, I'm not a man of poetry. And words of flattery are beautiful and sweet, but they are also hollow unless accompanied by action. Miss Edwina, I could stand here and pretend to be someone I am not. I could pretend to want the very same things as you, but I would be lying. I may not be able to offer the display of passion that you truly deserve. But I assure you that when it comes to action and duty, I shall never be found lacking. And I hope that is what will speak louder than any pretty words ever can. And your ring, when you get the chance, I shall need it. The Fields by Fairy Hallow. I was thinking we might hold off on leasing them this year due to the hard frost.
I beg your pardon?
The frost hardens the soil, saps it of nutrients.
That is very well, but you requested my ring.
Father's betrothal ring.
Did someone catch your eye at the presentation, brother?
I thought all of the young ladies looked beautiful.
Not particularly, and all the young ladies look the same, like young ladies. I should simply like to be prepared for when the opportunity presents itself.
If your silence is an indication you are reconsidering your declaration.
Is that what you want for me to reconsider?
It does not matter what I want.
I do not think that is true.
I am to return to India the moment my sister marries.
You will abandon her?
Far from it, my lord. She will be married. She will not need me. There will be no more reason for me to stay. It was the plan all along.
Why are you so distressed?
When will you leave? Immediately. Once your sister is married?
I presume so, yes.
And you will not concern yourself with finding a match of your own?
Why would that concern you?
It seems to me you will find any excuse you can to keep me away from your sister. That is it not? You simply do not like me.
Of course I do not like
you. Then tell me why. Have I done something to you?
So this is love. So this is love.
Anthony.
Absolutely.
So this is what makes life. I'm all aglow, and now I know.
And now I know.
Looking for
oh, this is not.
It's all right. It's
no.
Is mine. My heart has wings, and I can fly. I'll touch every star in the sky. So this is the miracle that I've been dreaming of. So this.
I will not be the cause of you losing your honor any more than I can stand to see Edwina in pain. You once saw her as your perfect match. You will find your way to believing it again. Please, please, Lord Bridgerton, Anthony, you must keep your word. You must marry my sister. You must marry her as soon as you can. Because this feeling that plagues us so, it will pass. It will become tenable. It will become bearable. And soon enough, it will be as if we never felt it at all. Mere passion. It must, because it has to.
The following day.
It is maddening how much you consume my very being. My family is on the brink of ruin. I am nearly certain every last one of my brothers and sisters secretly despise me. My own mother at that, despite the fact I've lived the better part of my life for them. And yet still, all I find myself thinking about, all I find myself being able to breathe for, you.
It's so amazing, and I would play it again and again and again and again.
It is maddening how much you consume my very being.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
My family is on the brink of ruin. I am nearly certain every last one of my brothers and sisters secretly despise me. My own mother at that, despite the fact I've lived the better part of my life for them. And yet still, all I find myself thinking about, all I find myself being able to breathe for, is you. You love your family dearly.
As much as you love yours.
I was fearful of losing you. It is why I could not visit you after your accident. I could not bring myself to. I love you. I have loved you from the moment we raced each other in that park. I've loved you at every dance. On every walk, every time we've been together, and every time we've been apart, you don't have to accept it, you don't have to embrace it. Or even allow it, knowing you probably will not, but you must know it. In your heart. You must feel it, as I do.
I do not think there is anything else to say. Other than that, I love you too.
Finally!
I want a life that suits us both. I know I am imperfect, but I will humble myself before you because I cannot imagine my life without you, and that is why I wish to marry you.